Joining us now is the Reverend Anthony Turney. He's the associate pastor at Grace Cathedral, and he's openly gay. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Tim. It's great to be here.
What's it like being openly gay pastor at Grace Cathedral?
Grace Cathedral has for many, many years been, as Cecil Williams in the previous segment called it, a beloved community. And gays, lesbians, transgender people have been welcome at Grace Cathedral for as long as I know, and that's going back many decades.
Well, you just don't get the feeling, being in San Francisco, we were talking a lot about, you know, district, and we have our Castro district, that on top of Nob Hill, this amazing, amazing church is open to gays and lesbians.
Well, in some sense, I don't know how it can't be. If it's a Christian church, Jesus told us to love our neighbor, and that's what we're doing up there. And our neighbor is not categorized. It's not some neighbors, not other neighbors. It's all neighbors. So that's why. And we have gay clergy. Some of our leadership in the cathedral, the lay leadership, are gay. There's a significant number of gay and lesbian and transgender people in the congregation. And of course, I think part of the reason is that Grace Cathedral is the place in San Francisco that if you, for when 9/11 occurred, the community gathered at Grace Cathedral. When we did a service for Matthew Shepard, and 1,000 people turned up for that service. So we are very much a community church. And so I think it's appropriate for us to be welcoming in every way possible. And one of the things we've done, which is a lead into one of the things I know I want to talk about, is that for years, the AIDS Memorial quilt was displayed at the cathedral. And in fact, we have a chapel set aside that's called the AIDS Interfaith Memorial Chapel, in which is the last artwork that Keith Haring did, which is this extraordinary altarpiece. Done in a white gold. It's there to be seen every day of the week that the church is open. And in that chapel is a section of the quilt that has been there since 1989. It's rotated, but there's always been, it is the longest running display, ongoing display of the quilt anywhere.
I didn't know that.
Well, forgive me for not knowing that, because that's, you know, I'm a third generation San Franciscan gay man, and I should have known that.
Well, the AIDS Memorial Chapel is one of those kind of unknown treasures in the city. So hopefully many of your viewers...
I've been to the chapel and I knew about the Keith Haring. I think that's a great tie-in to, you know, to the community.
Yeah.
Well, you're also here to talk about the Keiskamma Altarpiece.
Yes.
And I'm just going to hold this up and show it to the people that are watching at home. We do have some footage to run over this interview.
Great.
But we don't have a lot of time, but you want to tell us what we're looking at and the meaning of
it? Absolutely. The Keiskamma Altarpiece has a real connection with what we've just been talking about. A very small community, a village actually, in eastern South Africa called Hamburg. It was named after by German settlers. Typically has been devastated by the AIDS pandemic.
Yeah.
The population of that town right now is mainly widows and orphans. Mm. And 120 women, as a project, initially to help them learn sewing, began to create this altarpiece. It is 22 feet wide, 13 feet high, as all altarpieces do, it has panels that open up, and it describes in three scenes, firstly, the devastation of AIDS. The colors are all very dark, as you'll see when you run the tape. Then the first set of panels opens and the colors are brightened and it illustrates the community of Hamburg. And then the third set open and there are women, these older women with their grandchildren. And the older piece is really like the quilt. It's sewn, it's a memorial, it's an AIDS memorial, and it's coming to the cathedral. It'll be installed on March the 27th and will be there until May the 29th.
We're going to leave it there,
wow.
Reverend Anthony Turney. We also want to send people to your website. They can find out more and go see this amazing altarpiece at gracecathedral.org. Stay with us.